myself, I cannot resist to glorify my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So today's topic is how a Christian can convince a Muslim to celebrate Christmas. How a Christian can invite a Muslim, can do a dawah to Muslim to celebrate Christmas, even according to their present fabricated Quran. So the first reference for this is Quran 19:19, where Jesus is called holy. He is sinless, he is faultless, he is pure, he is holy. And this good news, the Saint Mary is receiving this good news. So, the first reference to convince a Muslim to celebrate Christmas is that Jesus, even according to the book of Muslims, is holy, sinless, faultless, pure. And what is the meaning of Christmas? Christ, anointed one, the promised one, and Mass is the festival, the feast, the celebration. So, if any Muslim is listening to this, the meaning of Christmas is there, and the Christ, who is the anointed one, the promised one, Mary is receiving that good news that he is the Holy One, he is the pure one, he is the sinless, he is the faultless. So the second reference from Quran is Quran 19:33, where Jesus is declaring that he is, all blessings is on him, all peace is on him. Why? Because he is the Lord of peace. His birth is a peace and blessing. The day he was born, and why he was born, the purpose is there in Quran 19:33, his death and resurrection. Those are also the blessed one, and those days are also declared as the days of peace, as the peace on Jesus on those days. And the third reference from Quran is Quran 3:45, where the word of God is becoming flesh. So there are three powerful references from Quran. I was asking one imam when I was living in Islamic country, that what is the purpose that Jesus was born without physical desire, and he said this is a power of God. And I asked him second question, what is the power of God, what is the wisdom of God behind this birth? And he was speechless. He said, I do not know. And then I told him that the power and the wisdom of God behind this birth is that you, that is your salvation. He died for you, and he resurrected for you. That is the only hope for the everlasting life. So I'll encourage Christians to invite Muslim to celebrate Christmas based on these facts, even according to their own Quran. No other person is called holy, sinless, faultless in Quran, even Muhammad. And there is one hadith in which the Muslims believe that only the birth of Jesus was such a birth in which was not able to touch the baby. In all other birds, Saturn touched all human beings, but he failed to touch Jesus. So celebrate this. Christmas means Christ, anointed one, the promised one, and the mass means celebration, feast, and festival. So if you believe, if any Muslim is listening, and if he may start believing this, your Christmas is today. Celebrate it today. Make a huge feast, festival, and tell others the most biggest day, the most important day, the most blessed day in the history of mankind is Christmas. God bless you all and celebrate Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. Amen.